Hey, Facebook friends, we're here today. It is the day after Easter, and we're so excited about Easter and what happened, that there was an empty tomb. But we were just sitting here thinking and talking just a little bit about what were the disciples doing for the next 50 days. They were kind of put on a quarantine. Jesus told them, hey, don't leave Jerusalem. You've got to stay there. And the helper's coming, the Holy Spirit's going to come at Pentecost. But there was a 50-day window between the empty tomb and then Pentecost. And so we're just thinking through, like, what were they doing? And what were they talking about? What were they thinking? What do you guys think?
If we look back in John, it talks about them being in that room with the doors locked because they were afraid. And so we know that there was fear in that, which makes sense. I mean, there's unknowns. Jesus, their leader, their rabbi, has just been crucified. His body is gone. There's all this crazy uncertainty going on of him being not in the grave anymore. And there had to be some fear in that.
Yeah, and I'm sure the religious rulers may have been interested in finding some of the followers just to make examples of them too, to try to squash any of this continued, following of Jesus from happening. And so, yeah, I think there's a lot of fear in that there's this transformation that will take place once the Spirit comes. But yeah, they're just kind of in this holding pattern, and they do a couple stuff. Like they're like, hey, let's figure out someone who can take Jesus' place because he's no longer with us and he's kind of a bad egg. So let's figure that out. And they cast lots and
Well, he's
different
also
things.
dead at that point. So, like, that was the other part of it. It's not like they could just bring him back.
This is true. Yeah. So yeah, they do that and they're kind of just hanging out, it looks like. I don't know if you go to the grocery
They
store
go to
during a
Galilee,
quarantine
don't
like
they?
that.
Don't they go to Galilee?
Yeah, it seems like they spent some time in Galilee for a little bit. Not sure how long they're there. It seems like the Lord met them there. That's where the Lord talked to Peter on the shores of the Sea of Galilee and kind of restored him. And so that would have happened before the Spirit came 50 days after Easter. Yeah, and so there's a couple different things that happen in between there, but there's this real transformation then that happens for them. But 50 days to me is a long time. And yeah, how long have we been in this quarantine for? Have y'all kept account?
I gotta go check the notches in my doorpost.
Yeah, I don't actually know how long we've been doing this, but it feels like a while. Yesterday, when we had drive-in church, I think for me it was just like, oh, look at there's people. This is and so and then my wife got all crazy and she started going, hey, we could do, and I'm like, no, we can't do, no, we cannot do. And so I think for just that little taste of like how important community is to us was really good yesterday. And I'm sure that they were experiencing some of that too. They had each other, obviously. And but I wanted to, maybe they're cooking a little bit more, they're putting one of the disciples who had the gift of cooks. He's cooking some good food up for them, and they're doing some of that stuff. Who knows what they were doing? Obviously they're praying, they're connecting. I think they're probably excited too, right? Like, hey, this thing's not over. We didn't give our life to nothing. He's not just a prophet. He's not just, a good teacher. He's not just a wise guy. He's actually is the Son of God. So I think there is some probably some excitement. And I wonder, like, that energy that they had, like, hey, let's go. And no, there was always, there's always a one rule follower in a bunch. And no, he said to stay, we should stay. Let's just wait. Let's just wait. And so part of it, I feel like in our current situation, people are getting a little amped up. And people are going, hey, let's go. And I just want to encourage you, hang tight. Our governor has said this. She's not Jesus, but she has said, let's stay put. And we got a few more. What do we have? 2 more weeks of this? Something like that, a little over 2 weeks.
More days.
Huh?
Who's counting?
How many days?
I think it's the 30th. So two more weeks, 2 days, 13th okay. today.
Okay. So yeah, we got 16th. They got 50. So, hey, we're in good company in this thing.
Well, and Levi, that's why it's cool when Jesus does appear to him in that upper room, where the first thing that he says to him is, peace be with you. So whether they're fearful or super excited, he's just like, hey, yeah. just take a breath, man. Like, I'm here with you. Connect with me.
Yeah. I think that's our prayer today, is that we would just connect with Jesus, that we would, you know, we would not look at this time. And we've said this over and over again, that we can redeem the time that we have together, and that we can, you know, spend some time in scripture. Our new sermon series is that we're working on right now is really on working out. Everybody's working out right now in some form. My kids are doing like a basketball program and a soccer program online, and there's these live classes, and maybe you're doing Zumba, you know. Nate has been
shoveling.
Nate's been doing hot yoga again.
I thought it was goat yoga.
Why did you give that away, Levi? Like, I thought our Zoom calls and doing that was going to be private. Oh, well.
You went too far last time. So anyway, we're going to just pray and just really ask God's blessing on this time that we have together. You know, the beauty is we're kind of in the upper room together, and we get to do it via Zoom. We don't have to get to be in person, and you know, but we are in this together, and we're always better together. And so let's just pray this morning, God's blessing on this, because there is reprieve coming. And if you look at Acts chapter 2, there is this reprieve that happens. And the day of Pentecost comes, they were all together in one place, and suddenly came from heaven a sound like a mighty rushing wind, and it filled the entire room where they were sitting. And divided tongues as on fire appeared to them and rested on each of them. And they were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in tongues as the Spirit gave them utterances. And so, I mean, there was a reprieve coming, and there's a reprieve to this coming. You know, let's just enjoy it. Let's enjoy the Spirit being with us, and let's enjoy Jesus being with us, and that we can connect with them. And, but let's hang in there together, because we're better together. So let's pray. Father, we come, and we're thankful for who you are. We're thankful that you're a God who cares about us in our being by ourselves and being maybe with our families. I think of those who have split families and have parents in different locations. I don't know how they're doing that. And yet, God, we just pray for them and lift them up right now. We pray for those who are alone. All of us, pastors, we have our families with us, even though, you know, our kids are wild, and there's at least people with us. And there are those who don't have any of that. And I just ask a special blessing on those today, that you would meet them that are single and by themselves, that you'd meet them in a special way. God, we ask that you would just help us to be at this time, just obedient to what has been asked of us. And God, we pray for those who are sick, those who do have the coronavirus. God, we just ask that you would be the Lord of that situation, that you would heal their bodies. And God, that you would be with our president and our governor as they make really difficult decisions. And we recognize that society is much bigger than just lives. Lives are the most important, and yet there are other factors. And God, we're in a sense at war with a virus. And God, we just ask that we would be victorious as we come out of that, and yet we would be respectful and be caring. And God, that you would meet us in the midst of our quietness. And we're thankful for the quietness, and we'll rejoice in that today. And we're thankful for what Jesus did, that there was an empty tomb, and we got to celebrate that in proximity as it was yesterday. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Lord, I just thank you that we can come before you. And Lord, we see that sometimes there's times where you ask your people to wait. And Lord, I pray that you would help us, as it seems to be one of those times. Lord, no doubt in the time as the disciples wait, they were just waiting for what you were going to do next. And Lord, I pray that you would help us to have that posture. Lord, whether we're searching the scriptures to see maybe an insight on what you might do to use this, or Lord, how you might prepare your church for engaging in our community and culture once this thing is all lifted. Lord, I pray that you would just give us an excitement about how you can utilize this event and utilize this to change people's lives. And Lord, I pray that we would just connect with you in a deep way, knowing that you're going to bring us through, you're going to care for us, and Lord, you're going to make your power known in this. And so, Lord, I pray that you would start to build some of that expectation in us, your people, Lord, so that as we come out the other side, we just can proclaim your name even bolder, and Lord, show that our God is a God of hope, of joy, and who carries through his people. In Christ's name I pray, amen.
But I just thank you for Easter. As we celebrated yesterday, I just pray that we would continue to just bask in the glow of the victory over the empty tomb, Lord. And we just thank you for that. And God, as we are still in our quarantine mode right now, and even a little bit more so today with the snowstorm, and God, I just pray that you would just come into our hearts, Lord, that as you told the disciples, peace be with you, God, that we would experience that peace, that we would connect with you on that level, that our fears, our anxieties, stresses, all that stuff, that it would just be given to you, Lord, and that you would take that from us, Lord, so that we could just hang out with you and have you fill in those spaces in our hearts and in our lives, God. So we just thank you for today. We thank you that the time that we do have is able to be used for things like doing stuff like this together, to connect with you, to dig into your word. But God, yep, we recognize that some people are alone. Some people are in situations that are more stressful and more trying, God, and we lift them up to you. Let your peace be with them as well, and just pray that it would cover all of us right where we need it today. And we give this day to you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. See you guys tomorrow. We'll be back on praying and just talking a little bit beforehand, but we'll see you tomorrow, and then we'll see you again on Sunday for a service together, because remember, we are better together.